next on Hollywood Uncensored. Britney Spears melts down in L.A. Lindsay Lohan and Pam Anderson make headline news. We're out on the town with Jack Nicholson, Katherine Heigl, and Jessica Alba. And we'll tell you why you might be closer than you think to owning a piece of Russell Crowe, George Clooney, or even Johnny Depp. All this and find out which of Hollywood's leading men are best friends on and off screen. An all-new Hollywood Uncensored starts now.
Hi, Hollywood Uncensored.
Welcome to an outrageous episode of Hollywood Uncensored. And how could we not start off this edition with a Britney update? Here we go. Drama was the word in the land of Spears last week after the pop wreck bought herself a visit from several, yes, several police officers and an ambulance ride to a local hospital. HU has the full story on Britney's wild night, coming up after the headlines. But hang on, earlier in the week, B caused several headaches when she failed to show up for a fifth custody deposition in a row. Fed up with Brit's K-Fed feud, her lawyers then asked to be removed from her case. For the record, that would make them the third set of lawyers to quit Brit. Oops, she did it again, and again, and again. But there is some good pop mommy news. Brit actually showed 2 hours late to schedule depot number 6. And after just 14 minutes, she was out of there. Britney's scheduled to continue fielding questions at a later date. But at the rate she's going, K-Fed's legal team may see her for about 20 minutes on the 10th of never. In other news, Hollywood's other celeb-wreck has fallen off the wagon. Yes, cameras caught our favorite rehab regular, Lindsay Lohan, toasting in the new year with champagne. Rumors of Lindsay's return to drinking have been around for weeks, but only now can HU bring you actual footage straight from Italy. Her people say that Lilo immediately called her sponsor and is back on the road to sobriety. Also in Lilo news, rumor has it the star has been hitting up her friends for cash. And poor Lilo just got back to the States after visiting Italy, where she took in the local beauty. Literally. Lindsay was seen with 3 different Italian men in a 24-hour period. You know what they say, when in Rome. A big congratulations to Nicole Kidman and her husband, country singer Keith Urban. The Aussie couple is expecting their first child together. From all of us here at HU, congrats on the kid, man. Just because the devil wore Prada doesn't mean Anne Hathaway has to. We're guessing the actress prefers Lancôme these days. The French cosmetics company announced Anne as their newest brand ambassador. Or as the normal people will call her, the face of Lancôme. Not a bad gig if you can get it. Congrats, Anne.
Hollywood Uncensored is now still uncensored. Garen Mitchell, BBC, it's all good.
Okay, here's the whole story on last week's Britney drama. Reports are the whole mess began when Kevin Federline's bodyguards arrived at Brit's house to pick up their 2 sons at 7 p.m. That began a 3-hour standoff. At 8:20, Kevin's bodyguards were still there when his attorney and 4 police cars arrived after Britney locked herself in a room with one of their sons. Fire trucks and paramedics showed up at 11 p.m., just as Britney is strapped to a gurney and put in an ambulance. It's 11:55, and in this clip, courtesy of CelebTV.com, police are now escorting the ambulance to the hospital. We can even see Britney being attended to by paramedics. At 12:40, our cameras caught up as Brit's escort arrived at Cedars-Sinai Hospital. A short time later, Brit's pal Sam Lufty also arrived, as did K-Fed. He's hiding to avoid being photographed, but he's there. Kevin's bodyguard even gave us an update.
It's good.
It became a full-blown circus when interior designer to the stars Bobby Trendy showed up and held a vigil for Britney.
I hope this doesn't end up like Anna Nicole saga with the Howard K. Stern, Kevin Federline, the baby drama fighting over. It's a stage for drama.
By 3:45, a hospital source confirmed Britney has been listed as a special needs patient and was put in 72-hour mental lockdown. And at 5 a.m., K-Fed finally got to take the boys home. A little over 24 hours into her lockdown, Britt was released and declared clean of all illegal drugs and alcohol. But not before self-appointed self-help guru Dr. Phil McGraw used Britt's meltdown for his own shameless self-promotion. The daytime TV head shrinker tried to stage a one-man intervention, but the pop star wanted nothing to do with Dr. Phil and checked out. So what exactly caused Britney to snap? No one's really sure. Maybe she got tired of Jamie Lynn grabbing all the Spears family bad press. Anyway, following Thursday's excitement, lawyers for K-Fed were in court the next day. A judge has since granted him temporary custody of the two boys, while Britney has lost all visitation rights pending a hearing January 14th. Guess we'll have to wait and see if she shows up for that court appointment, but given her track record, we're not holding our breath.